And we don't really need to know that this person is taking a dump while he's about to get murdered. Welcome back to another video. My name is Tally and welcome back to another reading vlog. So today is Monday, Memorial Day, May 25th. There are 5 books that I plan on reading this whole week. And yes, there's going to be a lot of all-nighters, no sleeping, lots of coffee, and lots of reading. So I plan on reading The Outsider by Stephen King. We Are Not From Here by Jenny Torres Sanchez. This was gifted to me by my friend on Instagram. And this one was just released on May 19th. And I'm really excited to read this one because it's just a really powerful YA novel. I really love this quote in the beginning of the story, which is by Lila Downs. And si no peleamos por los niños, ¿qué será de nosotros? Which is in English, if we don't fight for the children, what will become of us? Next one that I plan on reading is The Beautiful, which I have talked about it a lot. And I haven't started reading it, which I'm so upset about because I've heard lots of incredible reviews on this. And I hope that I can finish it this week. And I'm also going to be reading Glass Sword by Victoria Aveyard. And this is YA, the second book to the Red Queen trilogy. Mare Barrow, she's the main character, and they are divided between the Red Bloods and the Silver Bloods. And it's such a great story as well. And the last one that I plan on reading is Elevation by Stephen King. This is a short story with only 146 pages. So I might begin reading this one for the week because it's just so short and I might be able to read it in like an hour or 2 hours. If you guys are interested in my thoughts and my progress of my readings this week, go ahead and keep watching and I will talk to you guys later. Bye! I just got ready to get in the pool because it's a very hot day. The first book that I'm going to start reading is Elevation by Stephen King, and this is a short story, so hopefully I'm able to finish it today. It is only 142 pages, I believe, so it's a very short story, and the font is not very large. It's very, very short, so I will update you guys as soon as I have any thoughts or feelings about the book, and yeah. Tuesday afternoon, and I've been listening to the audiobook for The Outsider. I started reading it this morning and I finished reading Elevation by Stephen King last night. This is a very fast pace and I really enjoyed it. If you are not into horror stories and you do want to read some of Stephen King, I would really recommend this one. It's a very short story and it's nothing scary. It does have like homophobia from other characters in the story, and I loved the cover to this, especially because it has like different kinds of illustrations in the beginning of each chapter. It was automatically a 5-star rating because of how interesting the story was. In the beginning I wasn't really interested in the topic of what the whole plot was about, but then as soon as you get to know the main character and learn how caring he is towards other people, I feel like you get to care about him, of his weird condition. He's losing weight without getting thinner. Appearance is still the same. He still has the same belly that he usually has, and he didn't want to go see his personal doctor because he knew that they were gonna want to take some tests on him, so he didn't want that really. Once you start the book, your main question is, why is he losing weight without getting thinner? He's never out of breath when he's exercising. He's eating as much as he wants without gaining weight. And I feel like a lot of other characters from this story, they always judge his appearance because he is he looks overweight, and at the same time he doesn't give about what other people say because he knows that he is not overweight, because he knows he's losing weight, and he doesn't really care. So there's other two characters who are his neighbors, and in the beginning they don't have a good relationship, and the ladies, they are lesbian, they're married lesbians, and the whole town does not like them because of that reason. And they opened up a restaurant in that town. They don't have a lot of clients because of that reason. The ending to this book was super amazing, and it's just like mind-blowing because of the whole theme and the title of the story, Elevation. It plays a huge role in the story, and I really enjoyed it. Stephen King keeps on surprising me. I started reading The Outsider by Stephen King, and this one is a little bit longer. It is 560 pages, and so I can read it a little bit faster. I'm listening to the audiobook as well, and right now I am on page 35. I think I mentioned that I started listening to this audiobook a long time ago. Never able to finish it because my audiobook membership canceled. I canceled it and because I don't really listen to audiobooks, it's just I forget what happens in the books. But I decided to buy it, and I'm gonna start reading it again. So far, it's very good. I have my coffee, I'm gonna read more, and then I'm gonna get ready for work. And I will update you guys as soon as I have any more thoughts on The Outsider. So far, I'm on my second book of the week. I have three more books to finish my TBR for this month, and hopefully I'm able to do that.
By the way, my glasses just got here from iBuyDirect. They're really cheap.
Okay, so it is now 5:27 p.m. I have been reading The Outsider by Stephen King. I am on page 63. And this morning, I just spent fixing my little key for my color coding, my color tab. Annotating. So far, The Outsider is very good. I feel like I'm in a murder investigation. There are quite a few witnesses with a lot of evidence. I have not heard of The Outsider by Stephen King. It's about an 11-year-old who is murdered at a local park. And Terry, he is one of the prime suspects. He is arrested while a baseball game is going on. Like in the story so far of The Outsider, I feel like it's very fast-paced and the characters are very descriptive. I'm gonna begin reading The Beautiful, and this is by Renee Adier. Hopefully I pronounced her name correctly. It's a murder book as well. There's a serial killer on the loose, and the main character is Lean. She is forced to flee her life as a dressmaker in Paris, and she is taken in by the sisters of the convent in the middle of the carnival season. A body of one of the girls from the convent is found. It sounds like a very cool fantasy story. So I'm gonna be reading The Beautiful and The Outsider at the same time. And I will update you guys as soon as I have any thoughts or feelings about the books. But so far, I'm really enjoying my reading.
Okay, so I'm gonna make myself an iced coffee because I'm really tired and I wanna continue reading. So there's a little bit left from the morning. That's perfect, I guess. We're also trying out a new coffee creamer, which is Snickers, and this is my first time trying it. So hopefully it's good.
This is really good. It tastes just like Snickers.
149 of The Outsider by Stephen King, and so far I'm really liking it. It's very intriguing. It's time to start reading The Beautiful. Look at that beautiful font. It's Wednesday. I'm watching Outer Banks, but I'm gonna update you guys really fast with my readings. I was reading The Outsider last night and I ended up on page 197, and let me tell you, this book, it's just getting way better. Something just occurred that really pissed me off, like all Stephen King's books do, because of the antagonists. But basically, I did tell you guys that it's about an 11-year-old who gets murdered. And the prime suspect is Terry, who is an English teacher, he is a coach, and he is a husband and a father as well. So there's a lot of evidence and witnesses that saw him that night. There's also a lot of evidence that he was at a different place at that same night that the little boy was murdered. And so now they're thinking that he was at two different places at the same time, which makes the story even more intriguing. And it has a lot of gruesome and a lot of horrifying things because of how the little boy's murder is described, and that's a trigger warning. The cops are very annoying because they just arrested this man without listening to what he had to say or without letting him explain himself before arresting him in front of like thousands of people. Oh, there might be a twin that looks like Terry. I am on page 197 of The Outsider. I went to sleep around 2 a.m. last night trying to do as much reading as possible, but so far I'm really liking it. Pretty fast pace because we get to, because of all the evidence and all the witnesses who saw Terry one place, but then there's a lot of other witnesses who saw him at another place. So that's the intriguing part part about this book, and I'm pretty sure that when we find out the truth, it's going to be very, very shocking and surprising. Okay, so I started reading The Beautiful by Renee. I don't even know how to pronounce her last name, but I'm on page 69, and I have to say it's a pretty slow read right now, and it has a lot of French language. I'm pretty sure it's French. It's not really that hard to understand or hard to read. The main character, Celine, she is escaped from Paris after a dark secret that she has, and her friend Pippa, another character of the story, escapes with her, leaving everything behind. I don't know how I'm feeling about it. It gives us the point of view of the killer, I guess, because there's a section on here where it says, I catch her profile in the glint of a shining brass sign. But automatically we know that it's the point of view of the killer. It's not human because he just tells us in a section that he's not human, and he's trying to understand humanity and how he's watching his next victim. So I kind of feel like the romance is going to be between the serial killer and the main character, Celine, for some reason. Keep reading. I'm really not interested in this one right now, so I'm going to keep reading The Outsider. I have around maybe 300 more pages to read, so I will update you guys in a little bit as soon as I do more reading. Hi guys, it is now 7:32 p.m. and I read
I was reading The Outsider before I started working, and then I read like a couple pages right now, and I made myself an iced coffee. But I am on page 217 of the book, and a lot of stuff is happening right now. It's getting very spooky and scary. There's a man with eyes as straws that just came out. Who's he fighting now? But that's not my problem. There's been a lot of deaths already in this book, by the way. Terry's daughter's name is Grace, and in the middle of the night, she wakes up screaming because she said that she saw a man in her room, but all the windows were locked and closed. So her mom comes and tells her what happened, and she says she saw a man with eyes as straws. This is not the only time that this man comes out. He also comes out in Frank Peterson's backyard. Thinking about Terry's situation, about being in two different places at the same time, and I feel like it could be something supernatural, and it could relate to the man with eyes as straws. So I'm gonna keep reading, and hopefully I'm able to finish this book tonight because I really want to begin the rest of my books. I haven't done any reading of The Beautiful, and I still have to read Glass Sword and We're Not From Here, and I have 4 days to finish my TBR. Why is it so big?
What is it?
It's bubble bath.
Oh, that's it.
I am on page 275 of The Outsider, and the suspense is slowly building itself, and it just keeps getting super intriguing. Ralph, the cop, he is finding all sorts of evidence. Okay, Bill Hodges was just mentioned on The Outsider, and if you don't know who Bill Hodges is, he is a character from the Mr. Mercedes trilogy, which is a book by Stephen King as well. And Holly Gibney does make an appearance, and she was Bill Hodges' assistant. I'm very excited to hear about Holly in this book. Good morning! Today is Thursday, May 28th, and I woke up in a really good mood today. I'm almost finished reading The Outsider, and let me tell you guys, last night it was a really bad idea reading it at night, especially midnight, because this book is freaking crazy and weird and spooky and scary and horrifying, and all the words that describe scary. And this has been like the scariest book that I have read from Stephen King, and last night it was interesting. I'm on page 431, so I have around 100 pages left to finish the book. I really like it because it's just like different detectives coming together. And Holly from Mr. Mercedes trilogy came out, which she was one of my favorite characters, and I think that once she came out, she made the story even more better and interesting. And not that the characters from the beginning were not interesting, but Holly, she's freaking smart, and I knew that they were gonna find some stuff out because of her. The killer is actually not a human. It's kind of like a monster and supernatural kind of thing, so which makes the story even weirder and freaking spooky. This book, there's a lot of blood, there's a lot of liquids, lots of descriptions of liquids. There's a part on here where there's a description about Okay, sorry. There was just a bug on my floor. That was so scary. So I feel like this book has a lot of liquid descriptions. Like, for example, in some sections, there's where King describes a character from the story taking a dump, and we don't really need to know that this person is taking a dump while he's about to get murdered. When I was reading this section, I was like, we don't necessarily need to read about someone taking a dump and waiting for the semi-liquid to gush. That's TMI. TMI. If you've read the story, you know what section I'm talking about. 11:45 p.m. I was on page 321 and my heart was beating super fast because it just got very suspenseful and I actually did not want to read what was coming next. It was very scary to read, in my opinion. That's pretty much what I have to say right now about The Outsider. Okay, so I received a new package today, and let's see what I received. I received my sticky note, my colored tabs. Oh, there's like 960 of them. Oh, nice, cool. Next. I have to build it? Are you kidding me? Update on The Outsider. I read for maybe like 30 minutes. Oh, snaps. And I am on page 450. We're almost there. And so far, it's beginning to get a little bit slow. I'm using the lavender chamomile product that I bought at Ulta, and I am gonna continue reading The Outsider while relaxing, and I am on page 469. I haven't had a chance to read that much because I was building my wood organizer for my markers and for my pens, and then I had to edit a video for my mom, and now I'm just gonna relax for a couple of minutes and read The Outsider, and hopefully I'm able to finish it tonight. Today is Friday, and I just received a package. It's like another candle. Friday. It is currently 3:23 p.m. Finished reading The Outsider last night. I'm really not gonna really state a lot of my thoughts about it until I do my book reviews. The Outsider was a really good read. Towards the ending, it was kind of like slow. The ending, like when they're trying to investigate who the killer was, it was very slow, and it gave us a really fast ending. And oh, here's the way that we're gonna kill the killer. There, the end. They killed the killer, the end. But that is all of The Outsider. I will talk about it more on my book review. And I am going to try to finish The Beautiful today. And I read a little bit last night after finishing The Outsider, but I am on page 84, and it has, let's see, 425 pages. So I have a lot of reading to do. I'm also going to start Glass Swords today by Victoria Aveyard. And this one has 440 pages. I'm pretty sure this is a fast-paced book, just like The Red Queen. Because in Red Queen, I think I remember I finished it in one day. Talk to you guys throughout the day and give you updates on my reading. It is currently 8:32 p.m. and I was reading some of The Beautiful, but for some reason I'm really not feeling the vibe of this book. For some reason I'm really not connecting to the characters or the setting or anything about the book. I left off on page 104, and I'm just gonna take a little break from that one, and I started reading Glass Sword by Victoria Aveyard. And I'm currently on page 25. It's really easy to remember events that occurred in Red Queen. So if you read Red Queen and then take a long time to read the second book of the series, I feel like it's no problem, because Victoria Aveyard does such a great job at including small details from Red Queen so we can remember what occurred in that book. I just got another package in the mail. Okay, let's see. It's the third book of the Mortal Instruments. So there we go. I didn't want this version, but I guess we're gonna have to do it, right? By the way, today is Saturday. I have my coffee, and I started reading Glass Sword yesterday, as I mentioned, before going to bed. And I am now on chapter 12 of Glass Sword. And for The Beautiful, I'm still having trouble. I'm reading it. I'm forcing myself kind of to read it. Really different writing style than what I usually read. Not that I would get used to it, but I'm on page 131 and I'm still having trouble reading it. guys. It's now Sunday. It's now Saturday night, and I haven't read a single thing. I'm still on the same pages of Glass Sword and The Beautiful. I haven't picked up my book at all today, which is kind of sad, but I have been editing my video for the giveaway and for the Q&A, so I haven't really had a chance to read, but it's now 10 o'clock p.m. and I'm gonna make myself a hot chocolate and just read for the rest of the night and see if I can make some progress, because tomorrow is the last day of the month and I'm hoping to finish my TBR for this month. So I will keep you guys updated with my readings.